हेलो फ्रेंड्स, सो लेट्स टॉक बिट अबाउट टाइटन्स एंड ड्रैगन्स। सो एज यू नो द वर्ल्ड इज वेयर इट इज गोइंग एंड व्हाट द एजेंडास आर प्लेइंग आउट। सो आई विल जस्ट गिव यू ब्रीफ बैकग्राउंड। फर्स्ट आई विल टॉक अबाउट असुरा असुरा और मैड टाइटन्स। असुरास आर अ क्लास ऑफ बींग्स इन इंडियन रिलीजन्स। दे आर डिस्क्राइब्ड एज पावर सीकिंग क्लैंस रिलेटेड to the more benevolent devas. They are sometimes translated as titan, demigod or anti-god. Okay. They constantly battle with the light beings or devas. So they are basically Danavas or monsters. So why am I bringing this? So I will tell you a couple of stories which are interesting and how they are linked. Now this is Bill Gates. Okay. I remember some 15-20 years back when people were discussing astrology in Yahoo forums, somebody said Bill Gates was a sage reborn. How funny. Because it shows total gross lack of understanding of what or who a sage is. A sage or a rishi or a seer will never ever aspire for wealth. That too, so much wealth. No matter what. No matter what, they will never aspire for wealth. They know only how to give or how to read or how to see things and maybe create universes, but they will not aspire for wealth. So somebody saying that, you know, Bill Gates was a rishi or a seer who was reborn as a rich megalomaniac titan, I won't accept that. Okay, I'll prove that he is actually one of the asuras reborn. Now this is his horoscope. He is born in this, just note this degree, he is born in this Gemini rising as per Indian astrology, 21 degrees 33 minutes. Just note this point. Okay, he has got three or four planets in Libra. Sun is debilitated. Okay, he has his ascendant lord Mercury. Okay, with Mars. Mars means real estate, land. But Mars doesn't like Virgo. He hates Virgo. And interestingly, he has Jupiter in death inflicting position. In astrology, it's called also called as Marana Sthana. So Jupiter is in third house, which means Jupiter is his killer, basically. Okay, Jupiter is in Magha. Magha means ancestors. So he will pay for his sins. Now let me come to Mahabali. Mahabali was a Daitya king, okay, or Danava, as I was saying, Asura. He is the grandson of Prahlad. Okay. So as per the stories, he occupied all the three worlds, and then Vishnu came and pushed him into the underworld. In fact, it is said all the seven nether worlds are controlled by Bali only. This guy, Bali. Bali Maharaj possessed all the lands of the universe, and he happened to be charitably disposed. Look at these words. He was charitably disposed towards the Brahmanas. Okay. So then Vishnu came in the form of a small begging Brahmin. And he asked for charity, and Bali gave him charity. Actually, he asked Bali to give just three steps of land, and then he took over the, Vishnu took over the entire universe and restored everything back to gods and humans. Now the agenda 2021, agenda 2030, all are related to NWO basically. It is not a conspiracy theory. It is, of course, you think these kind, I mean, look at his face. Of course, I'm not going to go only by face. Okay, even behind an ugly face, there can be a good intention. That's not the point. I mean, do you think with his suit and all this, he has good intentions in his heart for the world? Look at these guys. It's like all the evil joined in one place. So yeah, now coming to Bali, he had this thing that he possessed all the lands. Now, as per NBC News analysis, Gates is the largest farmland owner in the US, and I'm sure he will not stop at this. Only people with good intentions can stop him and his cronies and all the other asuras of the world. So basically, he is a titan reborn. He is not a sage reborn. And Sirius, or the dog star. Okay. Now, Sirius, note the degree. I will show you the degree. It is 14 degrees. Okay. It is 14 degrees Cancer. Note this point. So this is as per the tropical system. So 14 Cancer, you minus 23. Okay, 14 minus 23. So how do you do that? So in Cancer, 14 degrees, and in Gemini, you have another 9 degrees. So 23.5 degrees. So you get the sidereal position, which is 21 degrees. So basically, if you go to Bill Gates' horoscope, he is born in Sirius, the dog star, 21 degrees. Because this 21 in sidereal Gemini is nothing but the tropical Cancer 14. And by the way, I am born exactly opposite this point. I am born in 13 Capricorn, as per tropical, which is exactly opposite this point. Maybe that's why I don't have much wealth or little wealth, whereas this guy has got all the wealth of the world. Okay, so that's about Sirius. Okay. Shall I go very far and say he is the Antichrist? I mean, he is one of the possible candidates, no doubt. Because see, it is said that Sirius actually was a very powerful star even in Egypt and the ancient system. So Jesus Christ has got some relation with Sirius. That's what they say. Okay. See it, there is a statement also. Jesus and Judas Iscariot were aliens from Sirius and all that. So there was something to do with Sirius star when they were born. So they're just trying to mimic that. Okay, please try to understand that this is Dark Ages or Kali Yuga. So, what they are doing is they are putting the people who are actually mimicking the real thing. Why so serious? So, who says why so serious? It is the Joker. So basically, what they are trying to do is they are just mimicking that. Okay, but don't get fooled by this. Don't get fooled by people saying that, okay, they are sages reborn or nonsense like that. Now, Vritra is a Vedic serpent or a dragon or a demon, and he was killed by Indra, who was riding an elephant. Okay, Indra is the king of gods or Thor. Okay. So how do I link it to dragon? Let me show you. Okay, so now we saw that he is rising in Punarvasu, which actually is Ram's Lord Ram's star. So as I said, they are mimicking that part. And also moon is in Uttarabhadra. As you can see here, it is written Uttara. What is Uttarabhadra? Let me come to Uttarabhadra. I'll show you. Uttarabhadra. So Uttarabhadra is Ahirbhudnya or a dragon which lies deep in the ocean. Okay. I'm not saying all Uttarabhadra people are bad or anything like that. Don't get me wrong. I'm saying they are using those demonic things, energies. Okay. A good thing can also be converted to bad if these people want. Now this is, see, it's clearly, you can see with wings and all, it's a dragon. So this is Uttarabhadra. And what does Isaiah 27:1 says? Let me go to Bible. I'll show you. So I will come to Isaiah. By the way, most of the things in Bible are shown to me. I don't search them. I suddenly see something and then I get the answer. I mean, it is just shown to me. Even though I am a non-Christian, I don't know why God shows it to me. But that's good. See, because I am non-Christian, I am struggling to find that. Isn't it? Because if I was Christian, I would have known, okay, with the back of my hand, where is Isaiah? This is Genesis, Exodus, Judges, Chronicles. Did I miss it? Here it is. Okay. 27. So this was suddenly shown to me few months back, and I told you earlier also, in that day the Lord with his sore and great and strong sword shall punish Leviathan the piercing serpent, even Leviathan that crooked serpent, and he shall slay the dragon that is in the sea. Note this. That is in the sea. Dragon that is in the sea. Dragon that is in the sea. Bill Gates. Not only Bill Gates. There's one more guy, I think. I think Elon Musk also has Uttarabhadra. This is a symbol of Uttarabhadra or Boros. Okay, this is Mr. Jeff Bezos, another guy who wants to conquer the world. Uttarabhadra. Do you think it's a coincidence? I mean, this guy, Bill Gates, what about Elon Musk? Okay, Puravadra, cousin brother, just before Uttarabhadra. Great. Basically, Puravadra and Uttarabhadra are a pair. Okay. So Uttarabhadra, Elon Musk, Purvabhadra, this guy again Uttarabhadra. Do you think it's some kind of a joke or a freaking coincidence? And what do snakes do? They guard wealth. The snakes can make one rich, right? So you know. Isn't it? This guy. Not Sage Reborn. It is Snake Reborn. Not a good snake. Yeah, oh yeah, he's not a serpent, he's more than that. He's some kind of a dragon, but a bad dragon. Okay, so what does Isaiah say? In that day, the Lord with a sore and great and strong sword shall punish Leviathan, the piercing serpent, even Leviathan, that crooked serpent. He shall slay that dragon that is in the sea. So it looks like there are three serpents which Lord has to finish. These guys, three guys seem to be those three serpents. Okay, this is one guy, of course. This guy is another. And this guy is the third one. They all want to conquer space. They all want to conquer land. So basically, any titan or any asura wants to conquer all the three worlds. I mean, most of the Asuric stories, Titan stories, are similar in that way. Asura of the three cities. Tripurasura refers to trio of three Asura brothers. So this Bill Gates, Elon Musk, Jeff Bezos, collectively known as Tripurasura. The individual names of the brothers are Tarakashaka, Vidyunmali, and Kamalaksha. They were the sons of Tarakasura. Okay. In the end, they were destroyed by Lord Shiva. So, I mean, I know that they are the face of the Illuminati, but even then, they must be stopped. Because if we don't stop, they have this Agenda 2021, then they have Agenda 2030. And yesterday, I saw some ad. Commercial World Economic Forum. Own no land. And own nothing and be happy, it seems. You will own nothing and you will be happy. It's not that you will own nothing and you will be happy, it's that you will own nothing by 2030 and they will be happy. And you will be happy, it seems. And look at their nefarious plans. Is it a joke? So this is what, basically they want to take over all the lands, all the rights, all everything. Everything they will take over. Through this vaccine, they will track you because they will put wearable sensors and all that on your body. If you want to enter a mall, you want to enter a hospital, you want to enter a cinema hall or anything, you will have to show vaccine passport. So that means you cannot even enjoy little luxuries or little things of life without showing a passport. You will not own anything, and these guys will continue to make merry. So they are guarding all the treasure of the world. The bad dragons. Of course, there are good dragons. There is one good dragon who is. Near Vishnu, but then there are all these bad dragons also, whom we need to Quash. Okay, friends, thank you.